Hi everyone, my name is Tabitha from the education team, and on this episode of Let's Learn, what I want to talk to you about is goals. Let's Learn is a series where we walk through any given feature or tool within ActiveCampaign, and we teach it to you in 15 minutes or less. So we're not only going to teach you the strategic viewpoint of why you'd want to use it, but we're also going to teach you the technical application. So let's go ahead and dive in. What we want to do is we want to talk about our example business, the business that we use alongside everything that we're demoing for you today in the platform. We'll talk about what our goals, why you'd want to use them, how you can create them, and exactly what use cases you would create goals around. With those use cases, we'll dive into the platform and we'll go through a demo of exactly how you should be setting them up, and we'll close out today with some next steps. So, our example business is Boone's Bandanas. Boone's Bandanas is an e-commerce business that sells products for dogs. So harnesses, leashes, collars, you name it. But they also have a nonprofit side. On this nonprofit side, they host events. And these events are hosted at adoption and or animal shelters where you're able to then actually adopt a pet and bring them home. We're using all of the features within the platform, automation, CRM, forms, and we have a Shopify integration that connects directly into ActiveCampaign. So today we'll be talking about how Boone's Bandanas uses goals, not only for their adoption events, but for other things that they're operating within the account. So let's dive right in and talk about goals. What are goals? Goals are a really clear way for you to move a contact from one place in an automation to another. Think about what you want your contact to do. What is the reason that you're building the automation, and what are you looking for that contact to achieve? If they achieve said thing, do you want them to go to a certain place in the automation? And if so, you'd want to use goals. Goals can really help you bring your contact to the point in the automation that makes the most sense for them. Let's say, for example, your contact makes a purchase. When they make that purchase, do they need to receive any more of the emails that you're sending them around that product? Or do they need to go to the point in the automation that sends them an email that says thank you for your purchase? You can use a goal to bypass those emails and bring them down exactly where you'd like. Think of it as an anchor or a magnet. So, what are some things to consider when you're using goals? First off, where do you want the contact to land? Is it important for you to have them exit the automation and enter another? Is it important for them to stay in that place until they achieve the goal? Or do you want them to continue in the automation based on them achieving that goal? Think about where you want them to go. What is the contact doing to get to that goal? Are they opening an email, making a purchase? Maybe they're clicking on a link or visiting a web page. Maybe they're getting a tag. You have the ability to use the segment builder to create conditions specific to your goal. That way you can say and determine exactly what should happen with that contact based on the condition being met. Next, is this going to be based on a time or date? If you're using goals to remind somebody about a webinar or an event, you can create that goal around a certain time in reference to that event. So you can bring people down in the automation based off of them hitting a certain time frame away from the event. So maybe 30 days, maybe 1 week, maybe 30 minutes. Now, after your contact achieves the goal, how do you want them to proceed? Like I said, do you want them to exit the automation? Do you want them to continue to move through that automation? Either way, the goal will track that it's been achieved or not achieved, and you're able to truly take that reporting and understand how many of your contacts are hitting that goal at any given point in time. So let's talk about using goals for your business. You can use them through webinar reminder series. Let's talk about this in context of Boone's Bandanas. Like I said, Boone's Bandanas hosts adoption events for a specific animal shelter. We do this monthly. We donate certain goods, like our bandanas, to the animals that need to be adopted. So it's really important that the people who have expressed interest in our adoption event get reminded about that event. Now, whether Tabitha signs up 1 month before the event or 1 day, it's important that I come into an automation at that specific time frame, and goals will help you achieve that. Next, think about a welcome series. If you're welcoming somebody to your business and they're just getting introduced to it, maybe what you want to understand is how active they are through your welcome series. Maybe you're driving them to click a link. Once they click that link, what do you want to happen? Do you want them to enter into a new automation? Do you want them to stay there until they click that link? You can use a goal for that. And last but certainly not least, we've given you a tag based on you being interested in one of Boone's bandanas. Now, I'm gonna send you a series of emails that are specific to your interest in that product. Once you make a purchase, you shouldn't be receiving any more emails regarding that product because you've now made a purchase. We can use a goal to pull you past the additional emails and end the automation based on you achieving that goal, making that purchase. So lots of different things that you can apply to all of your different kinds of businesses. Let's go ahead, we're gonna take a look in the platform and we're gonna build some goals together and see exactly what they look like. Okay, now that we're in the platform, we're under automations, what we wanna do is we wanna dive into a couple of our actual automations that we've built out around goals. Just note that the two that we're gonna demo right now are recipes. So they're automation templates that are already built out for you in ActiveCampaign. We're gonna go ahead and we'll click on webinar sequence. This is saying, what is the event leading up to? And we're gonna create goals that send out emails at each time of the event. So let's say the contact subscribes to our animal shelters list. Once they do that, they come into this automation that says, hey, we see you're super interested in our adoption event at Beverly Animal Hospital. That event is going to be hosted on January 27th. So what we wanna do is send a reminder up until that date so people don't forget about the event, and goals is going to help you do that. So 30 days before January 27th, you're gonna come into this automation and you're going to sit here in this goal until it's 30 days before. You can see that the way that this is set up is that the condition says, this is the date-based custom field is on or before 30 days before the event. So this is going to be set up for you already. You just have to pick what the custom field is. So now what the goal is doing is it's saying, when the event is 30 days prior, bring them to this goal. So if you, my brand new animal shelter or my brand new contact interested in the animal shelter signed up for the adoption event 14 days before the event, you would bypass this goal because you jump to this one. This one is saying 2 weeks prior, bring you to this spot. And what you can see here is a series of conditions that you set for your goal. You're essentially establishing the rules for your goal. First, we're gonna say when the goal is below the contacts position or anywhere. Here we're gonna use before because this is a very linear automation. If you are using an automation that had if-else statements with different branches, you would select anywhere. That way, if the contact was achieving the goal on this side of the automation, but you wanted them to come to the left side, the anywhere would pull them that way. Also, triggered this, if you're using conversions, you can use this. This is the other important condition for your goals. If the contact does not meet the goal, what do you want to happen? So you can either have them proceed, you can have them sit in that condition until it's met, or you can have them automatically end the automation. We want them to wait here until the condition is met because we want them to sit in that goal until it's 14 days prior to the event. Again, if they register 1 week before the event or 6 days, they would come into this goal. If they register, let's say 2 days before, they're gonna come here and they're gonna sit in this goal until the person actually triggers 1 day before the webinar. You can see that we're using time zones and we're sending them campaigns specific to that time frame of the webinar. Now we're sending them a day of reminder. Hey, today is your event. We're super excited. We can't wait to meet you, and we can't wait for you to meet your new furry friend. And then we're ending the automation. So as you start to think about the events, the webinars, the different things that you're hosting, start to consider using this webinar sequence in order to trigger emails around certain timeframes from your event. Next, we have our product interest targeted follow-up automation. This is the automation that we've set up that shows exactly what happens when somebody gets a tag that they're interested in an event. You can delete any of the actions that don't make sense for you. That way, it matches exactly what's happening in your specific process. You can see here that they're getting a tag based on being interested in bandanas. We're starting to send them emails over the course of a certain amount of time. And this is saying, hey, here's this product. We saw you were interested in. Let me tell you a little bit about it. We're sending, these are your favorite Instagram dogs wearing our bandanas. Here's a discount code. Whatever it might be, you're sending campaigns related to the product. You can see here that we have an if-else statement. And the if-else statement is saying, does the contact have a tag that the purchase was made? And was the purchase made from the Shopify store Boone's Bandanas? Instead of using this if-else statement, what you could do is you could insert a goal right here. Goals live under your conditions and workflow tab under goal, and we're gonna build this goal from scratch together. We're gonna say purchase made, and we're gonna click to add a goal. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna use our segment builder to go into our e-commerce folder and say purchase has been made from Boone's Bandanas. We'll go ahead and we'll press save. And then what do we want to happen if the goal is not met? Well, for us in this automation specifically, we want them to continue. Because if they don't make the purchase, we want to put them on a specific list. If they do make the purchase, we want them to enter into new automation. So because there's something happening after the goal, we want them to continue anyways. If we wanted them to stay in the goal until they made the purchase, we could use wait until the conditions are met. Let's go ahead and press save. And you'll see here that the goal lives here. So if we zoom out of our automation, you can see that if at any time the contact is sitting in these wait periods, they decide to make a purchase, the goal will pull them out of that wait period, they'll bypass the email, and they'll go straight to the purchase made. Because a true customer experience doesn't send somebody emails about a product after they've purchased the product, it sends you a thank you for purchasing. It sends you a, hey, here's how you can use your product. So we're making sure to create these really beautifully crafted dynamic experiences around exactly what you want your customers to do. There are many types of automations that you can use around goals and many different use cases for the things that you can create them around. These are just a few examples of common things that can help you get started using our automations templates. So, let's talk about some next steps now that you've set up your first goals. Go ahead and sign up for our office hours. If you're finding that you're stumbling upon the webinar series or you're not sure exactly how to set up your goal for that specific automation, sign up for office hours. It's a live session hosted 3 times a week where my awesome teammate Shiv answers your questions around anything in the platform. Join our community. You can see exactly how customers just like yourself are using goals and have set up goals and ways to really operate successfully for their business. And always give a subscribe to our YouTube channel as you can get more content and videos just like this so that you can learn all the different things about the platform. Until then, happy automating, happy setting up your goals. We can't wait to see what you build and we're super excited for you. Thanks so much.